in a way, I continue Dr. Naumov's presentation. Anthropomorphism could be described as being a production of analogies generated by human cognition. The Cambridge Dictionary defined it as the showing of treating of animals, gods, and objects as if they are human in appearance, character, or behavior, thus showing the broad potential of analogies between human beings and the surrounding world. As a result, it's not surprised that anthropomorphism is a universal cultural trait present in all cultures at all times. While in the Southeastern European prehistory, anthropomorphism is visible in many various instances in material culture, with the exception of Dr. Goce Naumov's 2010 holistic study in Documenta Prehistorica, the research on this subject has been focused only on anthropomorphic figurines. Consequently, the present paper will try to demonstrate the complexity of this topic in the emergent complex chalcolithic societies using the Gumelnica-Karanovo tradition as a case study. The Southeastern Europe in the chalcolithic period was characterized by the emergence of complex societies, which is made apparent in the growth of the settlement size and in the dynamic of settling, since the chalcolithic waterland dovetail settlements were periodically fired, abandoned, and resettled. Their material culture was complex, consisting of sophisticated products issued from the Neolithic package brought into the Balkans by the Near East colonists. Besides the objects made of perishable materials, a variety of objects made of clay, stone, bone, metals, or shell exists. The unique mortuary deposition of object, which is very visible in the Varna cemetery, supports here the identification of the emergence of a stratified society, probably a sort of chiefdom. Diverse types of objects found in the Gumelnica-Karanovo tradition show various degrees of analogy with a human body, which is an index of a rhetoric configuration of the material culture framed by anthropomorphism. The use of a human body as main reference for the chalcolithic material culture could be explained by the fact people use familiar concepts, like the human body, in order to explain the unknown. In the archaeological record of the Gumelnica-Karanovo tradition, the categories of objects have different degrees of anthropomorphic iconicity. For example, there are simple functional vases, okay, that copy the proportion of the female torso. Vases with definite anatomical details referring to gender, or vases with limbs but with non-human proportions. Starting with the Neolithic, the material culture of Southeastern Europe creating a parallel world, analogous to the real one, which is a world of miniatures. This analogous world presented various elements from the real world, such as supernatural entities or human characters, vases, stamps, ovens, houses. Due to the existence of this miniature world, it is possible to recreate a part of the chalcolithic cultural categories, including the ones that were viewed as in a symbolical relationship with a human body. The connection with a human body was based on the functional analogy that anthropomorphic object, similar to the human body which contains blood, and with the exception of stamps, were containers which could hold liquids, objects, or fire. The analogy between the human body and ceramic containers was highlighted by ethnography in different parts of the world. To cite only the seminal study, Why Pots Are Decorated, by Nicholas David, Judith Turner, and Gozo Gavwa, and it is a result of various rites of passage analogous to the cooking of clay pots. Even today, scholars describe the shape of the vase by making references to the parts of the human body. When analyzing from a cognitive perspective the anthropomorphic cultural productions, one can observe that the human body possesses a rhetoric character since it allows fragments to be perceived as wholes. For example, to evoke a whole body of a character or of a spiritual entity, it is sufficient to present its face. In this perspective, for example, the plaster skulls from Ain Ghazal could represent the entire bodies of the ancestors and not only a part of them. Using the same rhetoric manner, in this Gumeyn's eponymous sidehouse foundation, two human skulls would evoke the bodies of two guardian ancestors. Within the miniature world, heads, hands, or feet or phalluses replace whole characters. The faces of the Chalcolithic figurines are always presented with closed eyes or even without modeled eyes. The potter modeling only the volume of the head. Sometimes, due to technological or ritual reasons, the human figures were simplified, keeping only those features able to define the gender, such as ears or lips. As some figurines show, the high number of perforations in the ears and the lower lip were female attributes. This advantage of identifying gender in the world of miniature provides a way of identifying the gender of some large-scale anthropomorphic images from the archaeological record, as, for example, the so-called mask from the Varna necropolis cenotaphs. A cenotaph is an empty tomb in honor of a person or a group of people whose remains are elsewhere. Therefore, any object deposited inside it was in a relationship of meaning with a missing person. Among the cenotaphs in the Varna necropolis, there are three containing human figures modeled of clay. These anthropomorphic life-size objects, labeled as masks, were decorated with gold pieces and shell bead necklaces and were accompanied by different ceramic vases, spondylus shell bracelets, and diverse small items. If one perceives the anthropomorphic clay figurines or masks as being a rhetoric image of the human body or a metonymy, the symbolic burial of this anthropomorphic fragment could suggest an act of evocation of the whole human body through the use of contemplation of the fragment, which seems to be a ritual activity analogous to those from Ain Ghazal or the Gumeyn'sa eponymous site already mentioned. When comparing the human figures from cenotaphs with the gender miniature figures with large number of earrings and lower lip perforation, one can observe a similarity between the facial features of these two anthropomorphic representations, both featuring female characters. The decoration of the cenotaph clay figures with gold pieces of different shapes emphasize the trait of the human face. Therefore, diadems underline the curves of the skull, the round disc, the shape of the eye sockets, and the rectangular piece with rounded ends, the shape of the mouth. With a tradition where a part of the material culture is anthropomorphic, these gold pieces that complement in a rhetoric way the anatomical trait could have had an anthropomorphic meaning. When discovered in a different context than the funeral one, these metonymies of the human face could also evoke images of the human body. Those cenotaphs, without anthropomorphic representations, were characterized by a rich inventory of objects made of gold, copper, ceramics painted with gold dust and exotic shells, to cite grave number 4. The same inventory is to be found in grave number 43, which belonged to a male character, therefore inferring that grave number 4 represents a masculine cenotaph. Here, too, the shape and position of the body of the gold artifacts, like earrings, the piece to cover the mouth, bracelet, or scepters, together could evoke a missing anthropomorphic figure. In the case of the masculine cenotaph, where the shape of the object and their anatomical position is analogous to that existing in the tombs with skeleton, like grave 43, the anthropomorphism is non-iconic or metonymic, suggesting the existence of an invisible body. A similar example of non-iconic anthropomorphism could be assumed to be found with the Chalcolithic prestige package, a term I used to designate the standardized set of prestige objects made of precious metals and exotica that are analogous to those from the Varna cemetery and were kept or hoarded in ceramic vases. Their diffusion can be observed from the Gumelnitsa tradition, the Sultana site, to the Kukuten Tripoli tradition in the north, like the site Brad, Carbuna or Horodnica number 2 in the northern part of the Chalcolithic tradition in Eastern Europe. These prestige packages with a definite relationship with different parts of the human body could have had a similar symbolism with the Varna iconic and non-iconic masculine graves and cenotaphs. The hoarding in a ceramic vase of the body of a prestigious character could have also had a funerary character. Being analogous to the inhumation in vases, a custom existing in the Chalcolithic Southeastern Europe. A conclusion of the present paper is that anthropomorphism is a rhetoric cognitive process where the fragments or metonymies could evoke the whole anatomy of the body. Additionally, the analogy with different anatomical parts of the body, as well as a standardized relationship of proximity between different objects in the human body, could extend the possibility of decoding anthropomorphic meanings up to the non-iconic area. Thank you very much for your attention.